Let us continue with Standard 8 Chemistry, Chapter Number 3, Element Compound and Mixtures. In the previous class, I already taught you about elements and compound. Today, let us read what are mixtures. Mixture consists of molecule of two or more substances, that is, either elements or compound or both. They are mixed in any proportion in such a way that they do not undergo any chemical change. Okay. Mixtures are of two types, homogeneous mixtures and heterogeneous mixture. Let us understand one by one. Okay, what are homogeneous mixtures and what are heterogeneous mixtures? Homogeneous mixtures are the mixtures in which the constituents are distributed uniformly or evenly throughout the mixture. For example, when I dissolve sugar in water, here the constituents sugar and water, sugar which can be said as solute and water as solvent, here the constituents are distributed uniformly, okay, mixed uniformly. Some other example, I can say blood, then comes the air, salt in water, okay, tap water. These all are homogeneous mixtures. Alloy is also a homogeneous mixture of two or more molten metals. For example, brass, bronze, okay. These all are homogeneous mixtures. Now let me tell you something about heterogeneous mixtures. What are heterogeneous mixtures? Heterogeneous mixtures are the mixtures in which the constituents are not distributed uniformly. Okay, if I dissolve mud or chalk powder in water, will it get dissolved? No, it will not get dissolved. It will not get distributed uniformly. So I can say it is an heterogeneous mixture. Suspension is a heterogeneous mixture. Suspension, just like I told you about chalk and water, chalk will not dissolve, but it will remain suspended in water. In the same way, mud will also not dissolve, it remains suspended in water. Okay, na? So the example of chalk powder or the mud water, muddy water, it can be seen as heterogeneous mixture, or it can be seen as suspension. Okay, na? Milk is a heterogeneous mixture that consists of particles of one liquid dispersed over the another liquid. Okay, na? So it can be said as emulsion. It can be said as emulsion. Okay. Now let us read about the different characteristics of mixture. Mixture, it consists of different types of constituents which may be present in any desired ratio. If I want to make a solution of salt and water, according to my wish, I can take 5 gram of salt in 1 liter of water, or I can take 50 gram of salt in 1 liter of water. According to my wish, I can change the amount of constituent in it. Yes or no? So it can be said that the mixtures, they do not have any fixed proportion. The constituents of the mixtures, they are not present in fixed proportion or fixed ratio. It can be changed. Mixtures do not have any specific property of its own. Okay, mixture do not have its own property. Just like air. So for example, air. Air is a mixture. It has different types of gaseous substances in it. For example, oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, okay, na? Noble gases such as helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon, dust particles are also present. Okay, does air has its own specific property? No, it does not have its own specific property, but it has the property of different types of constituents which are present in it. Oxygen, it has its own property. Nitrogen, it has its own property. Okay, na? Carbon dioxide, it has its own property. Then mixtures does not have any fixed melting point and boiling point. Mixture does not have any fixed melting point or boiling point. Okay, then the constituent of mixtures, they can be separated by physical means. For example, when you dissolve salt in water, then if I want to separate salt from water, then what you have to do? You can just separate it by the process of evaporation or distillation. Yes or no? Evaporation, when you heat it, heat the mixture, what will happen? Just water will evaporate, leaving behind the salt. Okay, na? Now mixtures are of different type. Okay, according to the states of their constituents. Okay, the mixture can be solid mixture, solid liquid mixture, liquid liquid mixtures, liquid gas mixture, gas gas mixtures, solid gas mixtures. Okay, here are some of the differences which are given, you know, between compound and mixtures in page number 24 and 25. Children, go through it and learn it. Okay, now in the next class I'll be telling you what is the need for separation of mixtures. Okay, then I'll stop with this. Okay.